Welcome back. You're watching Logo and still with me for the discussion on the digital space. I'm Mahesh Murthy from Painstorm and Rahul Razdan from Ibibo Web. Rahul, a very interesting point that Mahesh raised in the last segment, saying that social network sites are largely free sites. I mean, if you want to advertise, you don't really need to pay. How does that work in to your own business model? I mean, that's not a good thing to say for a company that is based on social networking.
Okay, I'll completely differ with Mahesh on that. It's a worldview which is, I think, a little past in time, and it's something which, you know, which kind of, it's a very hypothetical thing. Like, if your product is good, it'll sell on its own. I don't think so. Marketing works like that per se. Very clearly, our positioning and our audience is completely youth, and the kind of advertisers that we've got on board. The most obvious ones are telecom companies. I think you name every telecom brand has, in a way, worked with Ibibo in one way or the other. The typical engagement model that we follow is that we've got social networking apps which capture the user's behavior in a social network and then try and weave a brand's message or the brand's key ethos or the brand's key experience as part of these applications. So the youth who use these applications use them because they are a part of their normal social networking behavior. The fact that the brand's message is tied in around this goes very well with audiences. So mobile companies was one set of advertisers that I mentioned. We've got people from FMCGs, Levers is on board. That's been a big boost for us. And then we've got automobile companies, Maruti, Hyundai. They're all coming on board for the first time. And I think their experience has been very good. And they're actually repeating business with us. So we've done one application and they're coming to us for a repeat application or a different kind of application as well.
Mahesh, do you have to do a lot of hand-holding? And are there lots of skeptics out there even now?
Yeah, I think we have to do handholding in at least in the case of the larger companies where our clients are a little older or the CEO is a little older. So, you know, the CEO watches TV, so it's very easy, you know, for him to buy TV because
and
TV's
it's also
been
measurable. In the sense he sees it as a money well spent.
Yeah, I mean, the net is far, far more measurable than TV. Yeah. I come from a TV background. I used to run a TV channel before this, right? So he, you know, it's easier to sell him because TV's been sold for 32 years in India, right? The net, if anything, has been sold for probably 6 years in India. And the younger ones get it, the young brand managers get it. So in smaller companies where it's far more critical, it's easier to do this. In larger companies, you know, it's hand-holding is required. And some of it is our own fault, the fault of the industry. TV, it's very simple to buy. You pay 10 seconds, you buy, and there's a rate per 10 seconds. You know, here you have cost per click, cost per lead, cost per conversion, cost per sale, cost per second, cost per impression. We have half a dozen different metrics that we sell on. And people just sit back and say, look, I'm not sure what I'm buying. Can we just hold on for a little? So a lot of hand-holding is required. But these are all good things that happen in the early stages, you know. And eventually, over time, I really see this becoming a 10, 12, 15% medium in India in the next 5-7 years.
Which is the best parameter to gauge the effectiveness of a digital campaign?
Well, it depends on what your objective was. If you want awareness, then you probably can count impact, which is, you know, how many pixels are seen by how many eyeballs. If you want interest, there's awareness, interest, desire, and action. If you want interest, you count how many people clicked and at what price they clicked, which is cost per click or cost per visit. Interest, awareness, interest, desire. Desire, how many people desired. You say how many people clicked and then came, filled a form and said, this is my name and my address and call me. And you can, you know, that's cost per lead. And action is, you know, how many people bought, which is cost per sale. So what do you want to do? Depending on what you want to do, you can slice it at awareness or interest or desire or action, depending on what your campaign wants to do.
Rahul, you know, one criticism against social networking sites is the fact that they're not very ad effective. Many people come there to quickly link up with their peers or their social grouping, and they don't necessarily engage with the medium. And that's what puts pressure on players like you to go offline as well as online. You have run a lot of offline contests, for instance. What is the formula going to be going ahead, and how can you bridge this problem?
I think the first thing that needs to be understood is that if we were to try and replicate other advertising formats of either television or print. So in terms of print, you're talking of the covered visual real estate. In terms of television, you're talking of, you know, a time duration of audio-visual playing. I think we need to break away from the paradigm. One of the first things that we've done is said that we are not here for selling banner space, what is called display advertising. It's tough. The problem is that the mindsets have, in a way, over the last some years, been veered towards expecting a similar kind of experience as was, you know, seen in other advertising mediums. The key part in social media is what no other medium can offer is interactivity. B, the entire ability to influence a social graph that I have. C, engage people in manners that keeps them coming back for more. This is what our, you know, social apps and our gaming applications do. I think these are opportunities that did not exist in conventional media. And I think the moment you try and show advertisers the fact that there are newer opportunities that are opening up, I think people see value and people move away from those expectations that they had. So it's actually a question of setting the right expectations and moving away from this entire paradigm of display advertising or, you know, playing an audiovisual ad in the middle of whatever else may be the web property. That's what we've been doing on the social network.
Mahesh, is it about a paradigm shift? And for someone who has been in the advertising business for some time, has handled various other media, what is the biggest challenge dealing with the digital space?
So I think the essential thing is to understand how people behave in the medium. I mean, you go to a social network because you want to meet up with people. You don't want to leave it. Unlike when you do a search, you're happy to leave the search page to go to a destination page. So hence, you don't tend to click on ads. So hence, you have to find a different way of engaging your customers on social networks. So what do? The most effective advertisers figure out how to create like a small social movement within themselves. So we did something for a large petroleum company in Malaysia, Shell, where we had people do a race, you know, along with their other friends on the social network within the network itself, which, you know, showed up one particular brand pretty well. There are applications you do. You don't just do banner advertising. What you do is you sit back and say, okay, this is not about just showing my ad. This is about giving an experience that the guy can be part of. And it's amazing. I mean, you look at an application like Farmville, 100 million people in Farmville. That's incredible. That's larger than most countries in the world, you know, and that's the number of people who play one application on Facebook, which alone has 400 million people. So you can get large audiences if you figure out how to engage them and spend time with them, and they will spend lots of time with you. So you can, it's an open ground. You can actually create the environment where advertisers and audiences like to be together. Yes, it's a challenge to get advertisers to understand the value of it, but it's not difficult. You can say, hey, look, you can advertise on IPL and somebody sees you, you know, as a ball whizzes by and, you know, you have a X moment of success and a Y Kamal catch or whatever it is. That's fleeting. But here there's somebody spending 45 minutes in front of you. So there is a value to that. And you can count everything. You can count the number of people, count the amount of time. So the amount of metrics you have is phenomenal. So it takes some time. I mean, we've come from 200 crores to 900 crores. It'll take some time. We will eventually become larger than most other media in India too.
Right. We head into a short break. We'll come back and talk about how niche this digital space is getting and what opportunities and challenges that throws up. Stay tuned.